Good afternoon, dear students. Yesterday we have discussed about the special consideration menarch, menstrual dysfunction and eating disorders, female athletic threats, osteoporosis, amenorrhea and eating disorders. So move on to the next topic. We are discuss about corrective measures for postural deformities. Deformities, which I have already discussed with you, these are spinal curvature deformity. In spinal curvature deformity, there are three types of deformities: kyphosis, scoliosis, and lordosis. Then flat foot, knock knees, bow leg and round shoulders. So these are the common postural deformities. So we have discussed about the causes and symptoms, and today we are discuss about the corrective measures. Our environment contains many forces that act upon our body, and sometimes due to these forces we suffer from postural deformities. Most likely, the postural deformity may be due to pull of gravity by birth, malnutrition, prolonged illness, etc. Postural deformities are of two types: functional and structural. In functional deformities, only the soft tissue, that is the muscles and the ligaments, are affected. In the case, the correction of postural deformities is possible through various corrective measures. On the other hand, structural deformities occur when our bony structure is affected. Physical activities and other corrective measures in such cases cannot play any significant role. In fact, in such cases, surgery can be helpful for securing the desired improvement. The role of physical activities as well as other corrective measures in functional deformities is very effective, especially during elementary school years. Indeed, physical activities or corrective exercises in various form can serve to counteract the effect of gravitational force. The correction of postural deformities should be a part of school education. The program for the correction of postural deformities is a school should be included to serve more than just an exercise for correcting a specific deformities. Students should also be encouraged to engage in exercises for increasing general strength, endurance, balance and flexibility. Methods of relaxation should also be undertaken. Along with the exercise, posture consciousness should also be developed among such a students who have postural deformities. There are a number of physical activities or corrective exercises which can be used as a corrective measures for postural deformities. Various corrective measures related to specific postural deformities are: first is kyphosis. So first we have to discuss about the corrective measures for kyphosis. First, lie on the back, or you can say supine position. When you are lying on your back, in physical education language we are calling it supine lying. And when you are lying on your stomach, so it should be pro-lying position. Okay. So now you understand what is supine lying and pro-lying position. So, first corrective measure is lie on the back in supine position with knees drawn up and feet flat on the ground. Both hands should be at side. Then move your arms sideways in horizontal position. Palm should face upward. Raise your arms upward over the head. Palm still facing upward. Hold this position for some time. After that, bring your arms back in horizontal position and repeat this exercise for 10 times. The first position is lie on your back. Second is lie down in the proline position, that is on the chest with hands on your hips. After that, raise your head and trunk several inches from the ground. Your chin should be in during this exercise. Your chin should be in during this exercise. Hold this position for some time and then come back to the previous position. Repeat this exercise also for 10 times. Now, next position is sit on a normal position. Sit on a normal position with a stick held in horizontal position over your head, hands well spread. After that, lower the stick and then raise it behind your head and shoulders. While doing this exercise, keep your head and trunk straight. Repeat this exercise 10 to 12 times. So these are the corrective measures of kyphosis. And as you know, kyphosis is a upper back round. There is a round in upper back. So this is called kyphosis. First corrective measure is lie down in a back. Then second is lie down in the proline position. And the third one is sit in a normal position and raise the stick above your head and above your shoulders. And repeat this exercise for 10 to 12 times. Next is lordosis. Lordosis, what is lordosis? Lordosis is a hollow back. Lie down in prone position with hands under abdomen. Then keep hips and shoulders down. Press your hands up on the abdomen and raise the lower back. Then bend knees forward while allowing hip to bend back behind, keeping the back straight and knees pointed in the same direction as feet. Descend until thighs are just parallel to the floor. You should be keep your leg up like in 90 degree, approximately 90 degree. You have like your thigh, until your thigh are just parallel to the floor. Extend knees and hips until legs are straight. Come back to the starting position and then repeat the exercise. Lunge forward with knees on the mat. Place the foot beyond the knees. Place both hands on knees. Straighten hips of rear leg by pushing hips forward and hold this exercise. Hold hold this exercise stretched position for some time and repeat it in opposite side also. Sit on a chair with feet wide apart. Bend and position your shoulders between your knees, then reach the floor under the back of the chair. Hold this position for some duration and come back. Lie in prone position on the floor. Keep the palm on your keep the palms of your hands on the floor and as per shoulders width, push toes up, keeping pelvis on the floor. Hold this position for some time. And last is, sit down with knees extended, feet together and hands at side. After that, bend forward, touching the fingers to toes. Hold this position for some time and then come back to the original position and repeat this exercise. So repetition should be up to 10 to 12 times. Next corrective measure is scoliosis. Scoliosis is a curvature in spine, and in this deformity your spine should be make C or S position. Scoliosis exercises are designed to correct the rotatory curvature of the spine. These exercises help in a limited way to decrease curve angle. In fact, exercises do not play a significant role in the correction of scoliosis. The affected people are advised to participate in physical education program, organized sports and normal recreational activities. They may wear scoliosis braces, some exercise which are described are lie down in proper position, that is on the chest, right arm should be upward and left arm at the side. After that, move right arm forward and left overhead. Press down with the left hand and then slide the left hip up. Stand erect with feet few inches apart. Next position, stand erect with feet few inches apart. After that, raise the left heel and lift left hip. Extend right arm in an arc overhead to the left. Press left hand against the ribs on the left side. Stand in the erect position with feet several inches apart. Keep left hand fingers tip on left shoulder and bend the upper body on the right side if there is an position C curve of the spine. But if there is no opposite C curve, which means if there is just C curve, bend the upper body to the left side. The tip on the fingers of the right hand should be on the right shoulder. Repeat the exercise for some time as per C curve. The example is alternate toe touches. Corrective measures for knock knees. Generally, the deformity of knock knees cannot be corrected through exercise during later childhood and adulthood. This deformity can be corrected up to some extent through exercise, particularly when it is detected The favorable result of exercise can be achieved during the phase of early childhood. So, first is horse riding. In one of the best horse riding is one of the best exercise for correction of knock knees. I have already told you about the horse riding when I have explained you about the knock knees symptoms and causes. Keep a pillow between the knees and stand straight for some time. Both the feet should be touch each other. Use of walking calipers may be beneficial. Perform Padmasana and Gomukh Asana regularly. So, as I have already told you that corrective measures or exercise will not helpful in knock knees under the condition of adulthood. And if it will be detected in early childhood or childhood, so it can be corrected, and for the correction of the knock knees, these are the exercises. Now, corrective measures for bow leg. The role of exercise in case of bow leg is approximately the same as that in knock knees. The deformity of bow leg can be corrected up to some extent during the early phase of childhood. During later childhood and adulthood, exercise don't play a significant role. The following exercises may be beneficial for the correction of bow legs are: stand erect with feet joined together. Wrap a soft piece of cloth on the both legs at knee level. Tighten it with the help of a partner. Try to squat as far as possible and hold that position of squat for some time. Come to the original position and repeat the exercise for 4 to 6 times. Walk for some distance on the inner edge of the feet. Walk by bending the toes inward. Perform Ardhamastendrasana, Garunasana and Ardhachakrasana are beneficial for bow legs. Now, corrective measures for round shoulders. Round shoulder is a common postural deformity. It can be corrected with the help of the following exercises. First is, keep your tip of finger on your shoulder and rotate your elbow in clockwise and anti-clockwise direction for the same. Hold the horizontal bar regularly for some time. Perform Chakrasana and Dhanurasana for some time. Now, these are the corrective measures for round shoulders. Now, corrective measures for flat foot. The deformity of flat foot can be corrected with the help of the following exercises. Jumping on toes for some time. Rope skipping. Stand up and down on the heels. Walk on toes. Sit down properly. Try to grip small wad of a paper with your toes. These piece of paper should be picked up by gripping forcefully using toes. So, we come to a conclusion that the above mentioned corrective exercises or physical activities should be done regularly for long duration to get good result. These corrective measures should be employed immediately after the detection of deformities. In the later stage, it would be difficult to correct these deformities. So, this is all about the corrective measures for postural deformities. Now, we are discuss about some causes of bad posture. Generally, there are various causes of bad posture or poor posture, but the gravitational factor is the major cause. Gravitational force acts upon our body when we sit, lie down, stand, walk, run, or perform any other activity. Our body adapts according to the action of gravitational force. A good posture helps us to align with this force properly. Following are the causes of bad or poor posture among human beings. First is improper diet. If we do not take a proper diet, the bones and muscles of our body become weak. We experience fatigue after some time. Consequently, we adopt faulty or bad posture. Due to an improper diet, a person suffers from deficiency diseases like rickets and pigeon chest that causes bad posture. Diseases. Second causes diseases. Various diseases like rickets, polio, and infantile paralysis may result in a bad or poor posture in a child. Chronic illness may also lead to a proper posture. These diseases may result in undue curvature of the vertebra. So, diseases are the main cause of bad posture. Some causes are by birth. A person may have a bad posture from birth, like kyphosis, club foot, and dislocation of hip are such deformities which might be present from birth. Next is due to accidents. Accidents may cause injuries to the body. These injuries may further lead to physical deformity or poor posture. In accidents, muscles of the body may be damaged permanently. This may also lead to posture. Severe burns may also cause physical deformities. Next is fatigue. If we work continuously for longer duration, we experience fatigue and we become lazy and lethargic. So, we adopt a bad posture. If we continue doing that work even after work, when we take rest, we tend to adopt a wrong posture, which ultimately results in a poor or bad posture. So, proper rest should be taken. Fatigue may be a reason, may be a cause of bad posture. Next is fashion. To be in sync with modern fashion, we choose clothing that create hindrance in a smooth functioning of the body. owing to these fashions, children cannot walk, stand, or sit properly. They adopt a bad posture when they perform any work. They forget the natural posture of body. Even tight and high-heeled shoes may change the walking style and physical posture of an individual. Next is imitation. Imitation also plays a major role in forming wrong posture. Children usually imitate others as they look for role models. Hence, they also adopt poor posture. They forget their own natural posture. Next is lack of fresh air and light. Lack of fresh air and light are also responsible for wrong posture. Lack of fresh air may cause kyphosis. Next is lack of rest and sleep. Lack of rest and sleep may take one slump and thus lead to poor posture. Next is lack of proper exercise. Lack of proper exercise may also result in poor posture. So, exercise should be done regularly in a proper way under good supervision. If exercise is done in a wrong way, then an individual may adopt a wrong posture. So, one should also know the proper method of exercise and preferably do exercise under guidance. Next is lack of awareness. Lack of awareness regarding good posture may also cause bad posture. If one is conscious or aware of postural defects, he or she will always keep in mind that he or she has to adopt a good posture while performing any task. Next is unsuitable furniture. Unsuitable furniture or uncomfortable furniture may also cause wrong or bad posture. Generally, school or college authorities do not keep in mind that unsuitable furniture may be dangerous for students. In fact, while making furniture, the age of the students should be kept in mind. School furniture must be carefully constructed to satisfy general health standards. The height of the bench should be such that the feet of a person are able to rest comfortably on the floor. A good back must give support to the spine at the thoracic region. Desk should be on the right height so that a child can write without lifting the shoulders or stooping down. So, good furniture plays an important role regarding posture. Next is improper way of carrying weight. Improper way of carrying weight can cause structural deformities of the body and especially of the feet. some writer, Dilagi, state that bearing weight does bring about chances in the formation of bones. Muscles of foot suffer from abdominal stress. If it is repeated for a longer time, it may cause poor or bad posture of the foot. Next is obesity. Obesity enhances the chances of extra stress on the muscular and skeletal structure of the body. It may cause flat foot, bow leg, knock knees, etc. Next is habits. If an individual adopts bad habits of sitting, walking, or standing, it usually affect his posture. In fact, such habits may lead to postural deformities of spinal curvature such as kyphosis, lordosis, and scoliosis. Last is other reasons. Improper daily schedule, more mental work, long sitting hour, and overwork also cause bad posture. So these are the causes of bad or poor posture, and I have already told you, if you correct these causes, these are the preventive measures. So that's all for today, and we have completed our fifth chapter, and tomorrow I will discuss questions.